Brian Callum mentioned the other day on the Stephen Crowder show, Louder with Crowder. Stephen Crowder actually asked him in the interview. He was like, what's going on with you and Amy Schumer, innit? Because Amy Schumer went ham, right? Amy Schumer basically put out a post where she basically tagged Brian Callum and said bye, right? Like, really, really bitchy shit. Called him out for the accusation and... And essentially gave us an indication that Brian Callen's Hollywood career is basically done. It's forgotten. It's erased. It's been finished. They press command in backspace. Regardless of what happens, the establishment has said, you are out of here. But it also made me think, and I think Steve McCallum, that's why he basically asked, like, what basically happened between Brian Callen and Amy Schumer that she'd go that hard at him, right? And kind of put his, you know, put his business out there into the wider public and not give a single fuck about it. And then, of course, when Steve McCallum asked Brian Callen, he kind of feigned ignorance. He had no idea why she didn't like him. And I was thinking, hold on, you know why she doesn't like you. But anyway, this is the post Amy Schumer put up from the original LA Times article. It says here, the LA Times just published this article by Amy Kaufman about the repeat offenses of Brian Callen. Thank you to the brave women coming forward and sharing their stories. You are saving women who have become after you, and to the comics who are annoyed with me for standing with these ladies, what are you afraid of? Available on my number in my bio if anyone wants to talk about Brian or any other one sexually abused. Stu, Marion, have a nice day. So that seemed really catty, right? And super direct, like super personal. You know, okay, they've got a grudge going on there. What happened? Did Brian fuck her back in the day? Whatever, we don't know. But then I remember, hold on, they know exactly why she doesn't like them, or why she doesn't like Callen especially. And it's because of this episode of the Firing a Kid from maybe last year. Do you remember when that story came out about Amy Schumer bumping some comedian during his headlining show? And basically telling him mid-set that she wanted to go on, right? I think from what I've heard via the podcast, or from what I know now about comedy, about stand-up comedy, it sometimes is a thing where if you are performing on a primetime slot and Dave Chappelle happens to rock up to your show or rock up to your stand-up
club. And by the way, can I just say something about Amy Schumer's pause, stand-up comedy? See, there we go. All due respect, she's not...
See, I told you he's getting into it. So it's actually, yeah, it's a common thing in stand-up comedy world where if you're performing in a primetime slot and a big comedian rocks up, they're allowed to bump you, quote unquote, which means that they take your primetime slot and you go after them because they're basically saying, hey, I'm the bigger act. I want to run through some stuff and then dip out. So it's kind of like you sort of like tipping your hat and basically recognizing the fact that this person is a bigger stand-up than you, or a bigger act, or maybe has more experience in the game, or maybe it's a way for you to get a better favor in the future. Whatever it is, it's a thing that happens. But usually it's the thing that happens before you go on, right? So if you're playing 9 to 10 and Chappelle wants to go on, and it's 8:45, the manager will come to you and say, hey, Chappelle wants to go on, is that all right? You'll say yes and you go on. But if you're on stage already, they're not going to start giving you the light quickly so Chappelle can go on. They're going to let you go through your set. He's going to sit down, and I think most big comedians do this. They'll like watch what you're doing, and then they'll maybe give you some notes or whatever it may be. Or sometimes if they go on before you, they maybe watch you after. Whatever the case, there is kind of an appreciation that, hey, I should acknowledge me, I should finish my set, then you can go on. But I remember the story coming out about Schumer doing the opposite to some guy called Brendan Sagino, or Sagino, which is ironic, Brendan Schaub. But she basically bumped him mid-set and basically got his attention as she was basically speaking on stage, said she wanted to go on, and he basically cucked out and gave her the stage time. And then after the fact, she kind of went through some, you know, some weird bullying things via text and sent him some really weird messages, and he basically, you know, showed her arsehole. And that story kind of, you know, ran its course because people realized, okay, as much as Amy Schumer was a bitch in that situation, the guy, Brendan Sagino, didn't really stand up for himself either. So, you know, it's hard to really get angry at Amy Schumer when the dude that's getting offended, the dude that's basically involved in it, isn't, you know, taking it that personally because he doesn't want to upset Hollywood elite. But when the story did break, they covered it on the Firing the Kid. First, when they obviously covered it the first time, they did the standard Firing the Kid thing where they're trying to pretend like they're not Hollywood, and they basically backed up Amy Schumer and said, oh, this is what comedians do. And they got a lot of stick from it. I remember it was one of their most downvoted clips, and they got a bit of stick on it online, on social. Then, of course, when more news come out, or they got more background story, more of a background of what actually happened via, I think, Legion of Skanks. They kind of reversed and went back to kind of trashing Amy Schumer. But this is also, I think, during the same time when people were calling out Amy Schumer for joke stealing. I think this was might be the same time when Kurt Metzger went on Joe Rogan's show and were basically accusing Amy Schumer of joke stealing, and it, Joe Rogan didn't want to get involved. There was a lot of noise about her joke stealing and people wanting to find out why ain't Joe Rogan going at her the same way he went at Carlos Mencia, which isn't fair, because I do think, looking back on it, Carlos Mencia, I think Joe Rogan probably does regret doing what he did to Carlos Mencia a little bit. I think he kind of feels like he probably maybe went a bit too crazy, essentially ended the guy's career for the most part. But anyway, when they kind of reverse tacked, the Fire and the Kid one on their podcast, and basically, you know, went a bit ham on Schumer, especially Callan. He was super spicy with some of these comments that he put out here. So let me get up here on screen. I think it's from 340 something. Yeah, there you go, 347. Cool, yeah, so let's put it on here now and listen to a bit of this.
And by the way, can I just say something about Amy Schumer's stand-up comedy? All due respect, she's not great. I have many friends who are funnier at stand-up than Amy. Amy's good, and Amy has earned her place, and her movie Trainwreck, she's doing great. But it's not like Amy Schumer is a great comic genius.
I think you got your reason why she hates you, Brian. Like, if you were confused and you didn't know why she basically went to free under the bus and tag you in an article that essentially is accusing you of raping women for stage time. Now you've got your answer. God almighty, man. This is one of the rare moments where Brian Callen sort of does away with his Hollywood allegiances and kind of goes ham. I love this. This is what podcasts should be about, though, right? There should be a platform for you to kind of speak your truth, because you're not beholden to the, you know, corporate Hollywood entertainment infrastructure, right? But as I guess the show evolved and got bigger, you know, they've all both got different responsibilities, they've got growing families, different people that they're employing that are depending on their paycheck. They then decided to kind of, you know, get in line and essentially, you know, kind of censor what they said. But this is a fairly honest take and something that a lot of people would probably echo, especially behind the scenes.
I get a kick out of this as a comic who's been doing this so long. I just get a kick out of popularity. Doesn't mean that you're really funny. I know a lot
which
of women.
Which is funny, sitting next to Brendan Shaw, been a little bit, right? Popularity doesn't mean, but hey.
And that I'll put up against Amy Schumer. I'll put their hour up against Amy Schumer in a heartbeat. I can give you a number of them. So it's not like.
Just off the top, Eliza it's not like Schlesinger.
Yeah.
Whitney Cummings.
There are a lot of women that'll hold their own and way better. So, which I don't like to get into this comparison stuff. But,
no, but you're doing it, aren't you, mate?
It's flavor.
Everybody's like different, you. But let's not also get it twisted. Nobody that I know. None of,
why are you surprised that Amy Schumer doesn't like him? Come on, man.
None of your dear friends are hearing a fucking peep out of Amy Schumer. We're not. It's not like, oh, Amy's getting up. We don't. I don't. I'm not watching her when she gets up.
Oh,
maybe because I'm just older. I've been around a lot longer than she has. But and I think Amy knows that. I think Amy's also
Jesus
probably.
I don't think she would do that.
She should be a little aware of her place as a comic, as but a stand-up
this
comic.
Is the problem, B, don't you think?
He went in hard on her, and it scorched earth. I forgot how spicy that was. But yeah, you should know. I'm nobody. You should know why people don't like you. You should have a good idea about what could maybe rub people the wrong way about your personality, and especially what some people particularly might be offended or might, you know, have a reason why not to like you, especially if he says something like that. That was spicy as hell. But yeah, you know, I guess they'll end up kissing and making up when the allegations are proved to be false. Probably not, but that was funny regardless. Anyway,